first things first, let's get the water started, and then we'll chat a little bit. The packaging has definitely changed, as you can see. And I'll put a link to the old video up above if you want to go back and check that out so you can see what's different. But the first thing that I'll say is different is that they're no longer suggesting that it's for two people or two servings. Now they're just saying it's one serving, and that means they've reduced the amount of food you're getting by just a little bit. Instead of 2 cups like the old version, now it's 1 2/3 cup of water, and I think that will increase the margin of error substantially for cooking this properly. 2 cups, easy to measure. 1 2/3 cups, yeah, not so easy. So, if they've changed the amount of food that you get in the package, of course it went down in price, right? No. Okay, so the packaging's changed. The amount of water we put in here has changed because the ingredients have changed. So let's see. Ingredients still start off with beef, and that's good because we wouldn't want to have less beef in here. And that is beef, rosemary, extract, and salt, cornstarch, sunflower oil, sour cream product, skim milk powder, onions, sea salt, beef flavor, mushroom, some sugars, brown sugar, yeast extract, white pepper, concentrated lemon juice, and garlic powder, pre-cooked noodles, contains milk, egg, wheat, and sulfites. So one of the things that I know everybody's been interested in over the past reviews is how much sodium. Okay, so this is one serving now, and we're going to eat the whole serving, unlike before when it was 2 servings, and they only gave us the salt content for 1 serving, and we ate the whole thing. It was a scary amount of salt. It's still scary. 1,440 milligrams of sodium in this one package, or 63% of the salt I need in a day in one meal. All right, well, I really love this. This was one of my favorite freeze-dried, add water and eat meals. Let's hope it still is. All right, my water's just coming to a boil now, so we still do not make these in the package. I still like to make them in my pot so I can get a good. There you go. Good mixture, all the ingredients are hydrated. Looks very similar. So we'll add our 1 2/3 cup of boiling water. Come on, every drop. Make sure I don't screw up the measurement. Should be a stew-like consistency when we're done. Stir that around. Now I'm making sure all ingredients are wet and mixed with the spices. Looks good, eh? Not really, but it will. It will. I'll just cinch that up in the cozy. Just put that aside for a second. Well, put that aside for 5 minutes, and then it says stir it again and let it sit for 4 minutes. And if my memory serves me correctly, last time they said stir and let it sit for 10 minutes. So we've shaved off a minute. I don't know what that means exactly, because I don't carry a watch. When I think it's done, I eat it. My guess is that's been about 5 minutes. So I've done about 5 minutes worth of work. And here we go. This is when you know if you've got the water right. And I think, I think I got it perfect. It's hydrating nice. So there's your 5 minute stir. Oh, look at those beef chunks. A little light on mushrooms, so don't see. Oh, there's one. Anyway, stop playing with it or it'll get cold. Alright, I knew that's been more than 4 minutes. I got a little carried away working on some stuff. Putting gear away that I'm not going to use tonight because I've been lucky. 4 days in a row, no rain. That's going to change. All right, first bite. Now, I know I've left this longer than the directions, and it tastes like one of the beef chunks there wasn't quite hydrated, but okay. I kind of figured this was going to taste the same as the previous version. There would just be less, and that's fine. It tastes fantastic. It's still my favorite. Oh, there's a mushroom. So still great. So, of course, I would give this a 9 out of 10, except for one thing. They haven't done anything about the amount of salt. And you know this tastes really good because of the amount of salt that they put in here. So I'm taking 1 star off Mountain House. You really need to reduce the amount of salt that you put in here. We carry salt. We can add salt to taste. You don't need to include it because for some of us, it's too much. And we can't take it out. Hope you're listening, Mountain House. But otherwise, this is a fantastic meal to take with you on the trail. So I'll say thank you for watching the Backcountry Meal Review. I appreciate you dropping by for a visit. I look forward to seeing what you have to say in the comments down below. And I'm going to put the playlist of all my meals right up here. The rating that I give each meal is in the thumbnail, so you don't have to watch the video if you're doing some meal planning and you want some great ideas to take with you on your next adventure. And of course, if you want to know more, you can watch the video. And with that, I will say bye for now.